power that own that power.
Really nice person. She's giving her award.
What's he doing?
Why would he do that?
He's a jackass.
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
Yo, I said it, don't.
Everybody says, who does he think he is? I just told you who I thought I was. A guy.
But you got the answer. You ain't spent $13 million of your own money trying to empower yourself.
It's like, shut the fuck up. I will fucking laser you with alien fucking eyes and explode your fucking head.
Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time. One of the best videos of all time.
If young Metro don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot.
Beautiful morning. Yeah, the sun in my morning bed.
Kanye West, one of the most influential artists of our generation, home to huge misjudgment and criticism. Throughout this documentary, we'll be taking a look through his career and his life, from the old Kanye to the new Kanye. Kanye Amari West was born on June 8, 1977 in Atlanta, Georgia. His father, Ray West, was a former Black Panther, and his mother, Donda West, was a professor of English.
His name was taken from a book of African names.
Kanye means the only one.
He wasn't the greatest at playing with others because he always had to be the leader. He always wanted things to go his way. Kanye's father and I separated when he was only 11 months, and at 3 years old, we divorced. Kanye was about 12 years old when he got his first keyboard. He immediately started producing with it.
Kanye sleeping out in no ID's driveway, waiting for him to come home.
He was like pest and 15, 16 years old, trying to hang around a grown man.
He sold his first beat to Jermaine Dupri, and he got $5,000. And he was living with his mama. We weren't used to having no money. I was like, you got $5,000.
Kanye with Jermaine Dupri? It was just amazing, man.
He's out here in the suburbs of Chicago. All the rap acts in L.A. or New York.
He wanted to get his music out there more, so he decided to move to Newark, New Jersey.
Kanye produced 6 joints on the Blueprint album.
That was the bulk of the Blueprint right there. It's the Blueprint for the Blueprint.
But having production on the Blueprint for Jay-Z was just part of Kanye's Blueprint.
Jesus Walk was on his original demo.
God, show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down.
Every A&R was, you can't rap about Jesus. You can't have that, you know, in your song. Nobody wants to hear that.
Gun, sex, lies, videotape. But if I talk about God, my record won't get played.
Huh? Nobody wanted to sign him. Nobody thought that he actually was going to make it.
He knew that Kanye was the best producer. And the bottom line was, he wasn't finna let all them good beats get away from Rockefeller.
Kanye was signed to Rockefeller August 3rd, 2002.
They signed Kanye, and within a few weeks of that, Jay-Z was on tour. All the Rockefeller artists were on tour, and they were in Chicago.
Right in front of Kanye's hometown, Jay stops the music.
Uh-oh. Kanye. Got some big news to shout. You want something?
When I sign an artist, I give that artist a chain in front of the world.
And what's up? You know, and I'm the newest member of the Rockefeller team.
After the deal was made Rockefeller, Kanye went full-fledged into making the album.
One night, Kanye was in L.A. working with Beanie Siegel and was just working hard. He was in a session real late.
It was between 2 and 3 a.m., and he was on his way from the studio to the W, which is where he was staying in Westwood. He was driving down Santa Monica.
He fell asleep at the wheel. He was tired, man. Lost control, car swerved, and he hit another car.
And had a head-on collision.
Steering wheel hit him, like, in the jaw.
Blah! Cracked all this, man.
And his jaw was broken in 3 places.
If it would've hit him in the nose, he would've been dead.
He was just barely conscious, and he just kept saying, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry.
He had several surgeries. His face was like way, way out here.
He was in the hospital for a while, and his face was all messed up. He had to get his jaw rewired.
He recorded through the wire.
Yo, G, they can't stop me from rapping, can they? Can they, huh?
Through the Wire is about the car accident.
I spit it through the wire, man.
Every line had like real life experience of what he went through.
And he was rapping through the damn wires.
I gladly risk it all right now.
He literally rapped through the wire when his mouth was still wired shut.
Once he knocked out through the wire, he was ready to go. He definitely felt like, I'm ready to drop this album.
The label was not ready to move at the speed Kanye was moving.
The label told him that'll never work, that'll never sell.
They still didn't believe, and they weren't ready to jump behind the project.
So he just took his own destiny in his own hands and did everything himself. Kanye put up $40,000 out of his pocket, and we shot a video.
Kanye was a successful producer, so he was able to have the paper to go ahead and fund his own video.
And I think that's when everything changed.
Yo, G, they can't stop me from rapping, can they? Can they hop?
So that is like, oh, yeah, we need to do this video, need to be seen, and we need to push this album.
1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And
College Dropout was released February 10th, 2004.
The album was incredible, man.
College Dropout was just straight, like, dope.
Ooh, she's so excited.
Oh, man, it was outrageous. It was outrageous. It was a groundbreaking, critically acclaimed album from the beginning.
His first week of release, he was certified gold.
He was nominated for 10 Grammys. He was the face of the Grammys. He was the Grammy boy.
And the Grammy goes to the College Dropout, Kanye West.
Kanye won a Grammy for the best rap album of the year.
Kanye West.
The best R&B song of the year.
Kanye West.
And the best hip-hop song of the year. Jesus Walks.
Everybody wants to know what I would do if I didn't win. I guess we'll never know.
She take my money, well, I'm in need. Yes, it's a trap.
That fall, Kanye began working on his second album, Late Registration.
I wanna scream so loud for you.
It means a lot to me. It's tattooed on my arm, actually.
Kanye also collaborated with film score composer John Bryan to bring a more theatrical sound to the album. He also created many classic hits such as Gold Digger.
Saying she a gold digger, but she ain't messing with no broke,
and Touch the Sky. Kanye released it August 30th and sold 1.6 million copies within its first week of release. And less than a month later, he created his first major controversy.
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
Kanye got mixed reactions overall, and President Bush would later call it one of the most disgusting moments of his presidency. And in 2006, Kanye West crashed the stage at the MTV Europe Music Awards.
But they want to thank you guys! Thank you!
Oh, hell no!
Oh, Kanye! You won already! You won already! If I don't win, the award show loses credibility. I appreciate it, man. You know, it's nothing against you. I've never seen your video. It's nothing against you. But hell no, man. I love y'all.
Hey, you should have seen the video, man.
Overall, Late Registration got critical acclaim and won numerous Grammys. After spending most of 2006 with U2 on a world tour, he decided to start working on his next project, Graduation, which incorporated a lot of electronic music. The album released 2007 on September 11th, the same day as 50 Cent's Curtis. Graduation brought many great songs such as Stronger,
Let that don't kill me, can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up, man, cause I can't.
can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right now, cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man. That's how long I've been on ya.
And good morning.
You could be my good morning. Good morning.
At the 50th Grammy Awards, Kanye got 8 nominations and won 3 of them. But Kanye's life completely changed when his mother died in November 2007, and his fiancée Alexis Pfeiffer ended their engagement, which began in 2002. And Kanye broke down after a concert just days after his mother died when Hey Mama started playing. After his Glow in the Dark tour, Kanye spent 3 weeks in Hawaii recording his new album, 808s and Heartbreak. He then announced the album at the 2008 MTV Video Music Awards. Listeners were taken back by the presence of autotune, and it was released on Thanksgiving in 2008. It got positive reviews, but it was a lot more mixed than his previous efforts. Some of the greatest hits off of this album would be Heartless and he also introduced Kid Cudi on the track Welcome to Heartbreak. And next year, we all know what he did at the 2009 MTV Video Music Awards.
Yo, Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish. But Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time. One of the best videos of all time.
Kanye's album got completely overlooked at the Emmys and only got 6 nominations and didn't win a single one. The Taylor Swift controversy definitely hurt him at the Emmys, and even people like Obama was calling him out.
Really nice person. She's getting her award. What's he doing?
Why would he do that?
He's a jackass. No. This, all this stuff.
That's what Pink said.
I'm assuming all this stuff.
Kanye's tour with Lady Gaga got canceled and he disappeared from the public eye. We later found out that he was in Hawaii and recording his 5th album, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. Starting August 20th, he did a new thing called Good Fridays, which ran all the way up till December and was a free music program which offered a free download of previous unreleased songs each Friday of a week. He then in October released his short film Runaway, and then in November released the album. The album was universally acclaimed. It also won 3 Grammys, one for the best rap album of that year. But for some crazy reason, it was not nominated for the album of the year. And the album introduced us to such powerful songs like Power.
No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. Till then, that the world's ours.
And Runaway.
And I always find, yeah, I always find, yeah, I always find something wrong.
You've been putting up with my shit just way too long. I'm so gifted at finding what I don't like the most. So I think it's time for us to have a toast.
To headlining at Coachella in 2011, Kanye released the collaborative album Watch the Throne with Jay-Z. The album got numerous nominations at the 54th and 55th Grammy Awards, but only won a couple of them, and was competing against Kanye West's My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. And it brought this classic song to the public.
That's your Christ. That's your Christ. So hot, motherfuckers wanna find me. That's your Christ. That's your Christ.
In 2012, Kanye released a compilation album on his label Good Music called Cruel Summer. The album was considered a mixed bag and was alright, but nowhere near the old stuff that Kanye released. But it gave us some great singles and some great songs like this one.
Lambo with your girl, she tryna jerk. Okay, Lamborghini Mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl, she tryna jerk. Okay, Lamborghini Mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl, she tryna jerk. Okay, Lamborghini Mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl, she tryna jerk me.
On May 1st, 2013, Kanye tweets out June 18th, leading several people to suspect that that's the release date of his upcoming album. On May 17th, in 66 different locations, this plays. That was New Slaves, the first single on his album Yeezus. It came out June 18th, 2013 to raving reviews from critics. Kanye's main inspiration for the album was a single Le Cabriolet lamp. That was his greatest inspiration. On September 6th, Kanye West announced that he would headline his first solo tour in 5 years to support Yeezus, along with Kendrick Lamar. The tour was also met with raving reviews from critics, and was described as crazily entertaining, hugely ambitious, emotionally infecting, and most importantly, bonkers. The album came out with great songs like Black Skinhead.
In the morning, and I'm zoning, they say I'm possessed. It's the omen, I keep it 300, like the Romans, 300 bitches. We're the Trojans, baby, we living in the moment. I've been a menace for the longest, but I ain't finished. I'm devoted, and you know it, and you know it.
And the beautiful but hilarious Bound 2.
Honey.
Close your eyes and let the word paint 1,000 pictures. One good girl is worth 1,000 bitches. Bam!
Honey. 2013 was also a big year for Kanye outburst.
Everybody says, who does he think he is? I just told you who I thought I was. A god. I just told you. That's who I think I am.
Come on, chill out.
You
bro.
Ain't got the answers.
Kanye, relax.
You ain't got the answers.
Bro, I'm asking you.
You
a
ain't
question.
Been doing the education.
Bro.
You ain't been doing the education.
Kanye. Calm down.
You don't have the answers, though.
Calm down.
Because you're trying to give me advice about something.
No,
You ain't got the answer. You ain't spent $13 million of your own money trying to empower yourself.
In June, Kanye and Kim Kardashian also announced the birth of their first child, Northwest. And in October, Kanye proposed to Kim. In November 2013, Kanye announced that he is already working on his next studio album, hoping to release it in 2014. In May 2014, Kanye and Kim got married in Italy, and on December 31st, Kanye released Only One, featuring Paul McCartney.
Hello, my only one, just like the morning sun, you keep on rising till the sky knows your name. Hello, my only one, remember who you are. No, you're not perfect, but you're not your mistakes. Hey, 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 hey.
Kanye also released 4-5 Seconds in January 2015, and then later appeared at the Saturday Night Live 40th special anniversary to premiere Wolf. And in March 2015, he released All Day. So help me God, the original album title was supposed to release in 2014, but in March, he changed the name to Swish. Kanye was also awarded an honorary doctorate by the School of the Art Institute of Chicago. And on February 8, 2015, Kanye almost interrupted another Grammy Awards.
I need some help. I'm back. Oh my God.
And later that year, he announced that he was running for president in 2020.
And yes, as you probably could have guessed by this moment, I have decided in 2020 to run for president.
In January 2016, Kanye revealed that Swish would be released on February 11th, and then a couple weeks later changed the name to Waves. And just days before the album was supposed to release, he changed it again to The Life of Pablo. The album was premiered at the Yeezy Season 3. Kanye also played a teaser for Only One, a game dedicated to his late mother, and got released 3 days later on Tidal. And then 2 months later, it released on Spotify and everywhere else. The album got great reviews, but it was illegally downloaded over 500,000 times, but Kanye lost 10 million in album sales. The album brought great songs like Famous.
From the very start, I don't blame you much for wanting to be free. I just wanted you to know.
And Wolves.
The fucking Wolves. What if Mary was in the club, but she met Joseph with no love. Cover Saint and Lamb's Wool.
And she was
we surrounded by the fucking Wolves.
Just 10 days later, Kanye announced his second album coming out this year, or supposedly, called TurboGrafx-16. In June, Kanye released his first single for the third album coming out this year, supposedly, called Cruel Winter. Kanye also released a controversial video for Famous. August began his St. Pablo tour in support of The Life of Pablo. Kanye had to postpone several dates in October after the Paris robbery of his wife. Kanye's always had a big interest in fashion. He started creating his first line in 2005, but eventually canceled it in 2009. Later in 2009, he collaborated with Nike to make his own shoe, the Air Yeezys. Kanye also introduced his first shoe line designed for Louis Vuitton. And from 2011 to 2012, Kanye premiered two women fashion lines. And in December 2013, Adidas confirmed that they had a collaboration with Kanye. Starting from 2015, Kanye started doing Yeezy seasons, premiering new clothing. The biggest one was at Madison Square Garden called Yeezy Season 3, in which he also previewed his album, The Life of Pablo. And in 2016, Adidas announced a long-term contract duet with Kanye West, which sees Yeezy lines extend to a number of stores and inner sport performance products.
I'd like to propose a toast. I said
Kanye West founded the record label and production company Good Music in 2004, shortly after releasing his debut album. In 2015, he made Pusha T the new president of the label. And in 2011, Kanye also created a film for Cruel Summer, the compilation album of Good Music.
And a week later, they do an interview with George Lucas and Steven Spielberg, and they're talking about what the next frontier of theater will be and how it'll be higher priced tickets and it will be something that's surrounding you and blah, 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 but maybe it's in the goggles. I said, wait a second. I just only did the interview to tell people that I invented it. I made it.
In 2008, Kanye revealed plans to open up 10 Fatburger restaurants in the Chicago area. Two of them opened up, but in 2011, he had to shut them down. In 2012, Kanye established the creative content company Donda, named after his late mother Donda West. The company would continue where Steve Jobs left off, and would give amazing thinkers a creative space to bounce off their dreams and ideas, and the goal to make products and experiences that people want and can afford. Kanye is also one of the co-owners of Tidal, and after his mother's death, Kanye revitalized the Dr. Donda West Foundation. Kanye and Rhymefest also founded Donda's House Inc., which is a free music writing program with the goal of helping at-risk Chicago youth. Kanye has also appeared and participated in many fundraisers, benefit concerts, and has done community work. Kanye West is among the most critically acclaimed artists of the 21st century, receiving praise from music critics, fans, fellow musicians, artists, and wider cultural figures for his work. Rolling Stone credited him with transforming hip-hop's mainstream. Early in his career, he was one of the first rappers to publicly criticize homophobia. Every album that he has released has altered the direction of hip-hop and paved the way for new rappers. And Kanye has also been on the Times Magazine's 100 Most Influential People list twice, even getting complimented by Elon Musk. Kanye has won 21 Grammys and is in the top 10 for the most Grammys of all time. No one can deny how powerful and impactful Kanye is. This is just the basics of Kanye West, and there's thousands of more things that you could find if you look it up. So if you are interested, I suggest looking it up on YouTube or anything like that and watching interviews. So if you like the video, like, comment, and subscribe because it's much appreciated. And if you want to see another video like this, another documentary on some other famous person or celebrity, comment the name down below and like it up and I will do it. I'm glad that you guys got all the way to the end, and I'll see you in my next video.
I'ma touch the sky.